Hey everybody. It used to be so simple when you do a loop, a for loop that is, and what you do, you just set it like this, for int, int as the index, and then you set the condition of less than equal to 10, and then you set the increments like that. That's how you do a loop. And just print stuff like that. Index is off value. And then you just print the index. That's how you do it traditionally. But now with Swift, they're trying to deprecate that. And I think that is not very good. In a C style, you just put in parentheses like this. The good thing about the C style construct is that you can, instead of just increment by one, you can increment it by, say, like five. And you can do that. And provide specifics in terms of the loop increment, or even how you initialize like the value of the index. But with the new Swift, the for loop is like this: for I in 0 to 10, whatever like that. And that's how you create a loop. So the thing is, they automatically increment the index by one. And if you want to have a custom increment different, like be the size one as an increment, you have to specify that inside the loop. To do that, you would have to do it like this. So, I feel that you can have it like this. 5 plus 2. But this is some error. Well, my beef is that we should keep the C style constructs like this, where you can specify a custom increment value, where instead of just going by ones like we have here, you can increment by, say, 5. And then you can specify the initial value of 2, which you can do here as well. So yeah, that's pretty much my beef with the development of Swift. Beyond that, my other complaint of Swift is that it's not good with JSON parsing. Like you can do it with like Java. You can specify into an object or to an array, and you can look through the array and then set the object within the array like that. But I found that a little bit difficult in Swift, and they need more development in that. So with that, I'll end it here.